The two light waves have to be coherent if we want to see their superposition as consistent, continuous. Now, what are the coherent waves? See, I will give certain examples of coherent waves and you can find out the condition for that. Both are moving in the same medium, same velocity. When this crust reaches here, this will reach here. When this trough reaches here, this trough will reach here, and it will keep on doing like that, and this will be a consistent superposition. So these two are the coherent waves. What is the property in them? Property in them that this wavelength is equal to this wavelength. So they should have same wavelength so that they are not out of step. Now, in 1 second, the number of waves should be equal to number of waves in 1 second. That means frequency and wavelength should be same. Then these are known as coherent and they will give a consistent superposition. Now, see these two, can I call them coherent? Their wavelength is same. Their frequency, number of waves per second, is also same. So according to this definition, they are also coherent. Crest and trough give darkness. Crest and trough give darkness. Crest and trough give darkness. Every time it will remain dark, there is a consistent brightness here because these two are coherent. At any time when this crest comes, there has to be a trough coming from the second wave. So these are also coherent. Third, can I call this coherent? Yes, this is also coherent. Why? Here the phase difference is this much. Here the phase difference is again same, this much. And here the phase difference is again this much. The phase difference is constant. And if I go to a distance of 1 kilometer, again the phase difference will be same. These are also coherent. Now you may question that they will not give intensity equal to 4a square, or they will not give intensity 0. My answer is, even if they don't give 0 or 4a square, that is not the criteria. Criteria is that it should remain same at all the instants. That is consistency. So whatever it gives, it will always give this added by this, this added by this, this added by this, in this part, in the second part, in the third part, in the fourth part. Every time this will be the situation. So the brightness will be same all the time. If brightness is same all the time, then these will make a consistent brightness. So these two are coherent. Now here there is a phase difference. Let us say this phase difference is pi by 4. If I go here and here, again I find the phase difference here is pi by 4. If I go 1 kilometer behind this, again the phase difference is pi by 4. So a constant phase difference between the two waves, that will also make the two waves coherent. Now we have our definition complete, that frequency and wave should be same and there should be a constant phase difference. Whatever is the distance. So now the two waves are called coherent lights or coherent waves. if these conditions are met. Frequency and wavelength should be same, and there should be a constant phase difference, whatever is the distance. This is coherent, and superposition of coherent will give the consistent light, whether it is 4a square, whether it is 0, whatever it is. So, this is about consistency and coherent. But how do we get two coherent waves? Do we have any sources? If I bring 260 watt bulbs from the market of the same color, will it give two coherent lights? Answer is no. And now listen the rule. It's very discouraging. No two sources of light in our nature, no two sources of light are coherent. Any two sources you choose, you will never find two sources to be coherent. It's a very strange thing. Then how we will do the superposition? So first we will study that why two sources are not coherent. For this we will have to study what is a source of light. In a source of light, we know that there is a vibration of electron. An electron leaves its energy level, go to the next energy level. There is no place here according to Bohr's rule, so it comes back. When it comes back, it leaves the extra energy in the shape of photon, light, or we can say a wave. This wave, electromagnetic wave, is the light. Okay. What is the frequency of this light? That is decided by this electron's oscillation. Okay. When we make a light, do we make with one electron? Answer no. We give energy, and that energy may oscillate millions of electrons together. Now, all the electrons give frequency. Do they give the same frequency? Answer no. There may be little difference, because every electron may not possess the difference of energy which is exactly equal up to the 10th place of decimal. There may be a little difference. What will happen? That will create a difference in their frequencies. So what we get from the bulb, from the source, is a mixture of so many frequencies around a central frequency. Like if central frequency is 400 nanometer, then there may be another frequency with that 400.00000019, and there will be another 399.00000098. Like this, around 400, there will be hundreds or thousands of frequencies. Mean value 400. Okay, that makes a combination of many frequencies. The combination of these many frequencies make its own signature, its own design, its own graph. I bring another bulb, switch it on. It gives the light, electrons vibrate, how many? Millions. Now, 1 million waves made by first bulb with different frequencies, 1 million electrons of the second bulb, they make different frequencies. Who can guarantee that these two combination of frequencies will be same? What is the probability of that it will be same? You will say, probability is 0, 1 lakh to the power 1 lakh, million to the power million, that is 1 upon million to the power million. So probability is 0. It is not possible to get the same combination, and it's very, very difficult. You know, there are so many people in this world, but if in a dark room there are 1000 people and they all are talking, you cannot see anyone. But when you listen their voice, you can make out that your mother is there. How? Everybody is speaking with a central frequency of 400. That is frequency of the human throat. Then how can you make out that your mother is there, that voice is there? Because of the combination of frequencies. From our throat, there are so many larynx. Every larynx make a particular frequency. So what you get out is a combination of frequencies. And that combination you will not find in anybody else. So that is why we have different voice for different persons, and that is why when you are used to a sound of a particular person, that becomes his signature. You can make out that it is that person. Similarly, it is for the light, and for the light the probability is very, very rare, so that the two signatures or the two combinations become equal. It is not possible. So there is no probability that two sources will be coherent. Now, what is the answer you are going to write for that? Why the two sources cannot be coherent? See, the answer will be, a source of light generates the light by vibration of millions of electrons. These millions of electrons makes a combination of frequencies, and it is not possible that combination of frequencies in one source will be exactly same of combination of frequencies in the second source. Therefore, it is not possible that the two sources will be coherent. So, if the two sources are not coherent, then how we will make the superposition? A consistent superposition we will not be able to make. Answer is not that we will be able to make. How can we create coherent forces? That is our next question. And we can make it very clearly. See, you have written this. So, how to create coherent sources and with that coherent waves? There are two methods to do that. How to create coherent sources and coherent light? There is one method that is known as split the source, and second method is reflection method. Split the source. There is one source here, and here we put a screen. In the screen there will be two very small openings like this. Now from this source the wavefronts proceed. Wavefronts. One point of the wavefront which reaches here will become a source of light, and that will create its own waves this way. What will be the frequency of this wave? The same as created by this, because this is secondary source. This is source S, this is secondary source S1. It creates same frequency, same wavelength, same velocity. Now, this any of the wavefront which strikes here, that point of the wavefront will become a secondary source as per Huygens principle. So, this will also create waves. Now, at this point, this wave will reach here. When this wave will reach here, it will see the source here. This wave is reaching here. Here is the observer. He see that source is here. So this person seeing one source here and one source here, S1, S2. See? Or even if we don't go for this, this person will see the two source. This source S1 is giving this wave. This source S2 is giving this wave. So he will see one source here, one source here. There are two sources. If there are two sources, then what is the frequency? Same as this. What is the frequency of this? same as this, so they are having same frequency, same wavelength, and whatever is the path difference, that will be constant. So these two are coherent waves. So this method is known as split the source, and by this splitting the source, we are creating from one source these two sources. The other method is reflection method. Here is one source of light and here is the screen. Okay, this can give light like this. What we do, we put a mirror here. When we put a mirror here, then the light, the waves which are coming in this direction, they get reflected and they go here. Now, for this person, this distance, yes, this is source number 2, this is source number 1. For this observer, he will see two sources, and we know that it is sending the wave fronts here. After reflection, the same wave fronts are going here. So they will have the same frequency, same wavelength, same velocity. So these two lights are coherent. See another method. We don't send it here and we put a screen here. We put a mirror here. So there will be reflection this way. Now he sees a image of S1 here. Now for this person, this is one source, this is another source. And what appears to him, that there are two waves coming from the two directions. If the two waves are coming from two directions, we know that they are actually from the same source. He is not able to see this source. To him, what it appears, there are two sources, but the wavelength and frequency is same according to Huygens' principle. So this is how we have created two coherent sources. So what are the methods to create coherent sources? Reflection method and split the source method. This is how we will create coherent waves, and by combination of coherent waves, by their superposition, we will be able to create the regions on the screen which will have intensity equal to 4a square or intensity equal to 0, which is dark. So after that, we will study the mathematical part of it, that what are the conditions for superposition which is constructive and superposition which is destructive. By mathematical formulations, we will find out the condition, and then we will move to the practical form of it. Who could do it and explain it in the laboratory, that this can really happen. We can have the regions of extra brightness and we can have the regions of zero brightness. That was also done in the lab. So that we will experience in the next lecture. Thank you.